Welcome back to The Checkpoint. I am here with Mr. Via Niluja, the spokesperson of Civil Aviation Authority here in Uganda. And he's telling us about the image of the airport and also talking through about the expansion and the works that are going on at the airport. So yes, we were talking expansion works at the airport. What should we expect after all this is done, the constructions are finished? What will be there for us as Ugandans?
When all these projects that we are talking about are completed, we shall see a new face of Entebbe International Airport.
Yes.
We undertook a 20-year National Aviation Master Plan, which was promulgated in 2014. And that master plan looked at where we're coming from, where we are, and where we are going. It is based on that master plan that we are implementing the projects for upgrade and expansion of Entebbe International Airport. Most of these are needs-based. They looked at the projections in terms of traffic that we shall have in future, as well as cargo. And because cargo traffic was growing steadily, that is why we put up that new cargo center with 100,000 tons capacity. Similarly, because passenger traffic has been growing, that is why we are looking at expanding the facilities so that we create more room for departing and arriving passengers. Just this year, one of the things that we are going to see before the year ends is the completion of the project for modification of the passenger terminal building. You already see the departure area opened up and it is bigger. The check-in counters are more spacious. We are now going to add a canopy to the departure road, and we are going to reopen up the departure road so that passengers can be dropped by the terminal building. That will solve the problem of passengers parking in the parking and having to push their luggage all the way up. That is one of the feedback complaints that we have been receiving. And that's why we've been working on that project for remodification of the terminal. So passenger will be using the departure road, dropped off and enters the terminal building straight. The other thing in these works that we are having is the expansion of the aircraft parking apron. Part of it is still ongoing and about 84% level of completion. We anticipate that it will be completed this year and it will help us facilitate Uganda's hosting of the G77 Plus China Summit, which the country is scheduled to host in December this year. You know, when you have conferences of this nature, it is similar or even bigger than CHOGAM. You probably expect every head of state to come in a private jet, and we are enhancing that capacity.
And that G77 is going to be here in
Uganda
in December, the G77 plus China.
Exactly. Yes. It is being hosted by Uganda as a country, but the airport as the major point of entry and exit is a major facilitator of such a major international conference.
Yes.
Because all those heads of state and their accompanying delegates will pass through this airport.
Mm. Talk to us about the modernization and automation at the airport.
Yes, in September 2022, we commissioned the project for modernization and automation of Entebbe International Airport. That project was funded by the government of South Korea and executed by the Korea International Cooperation Agency. It was a grant to the tune of US$9.5 million. And what that gave us, it came with a computerized maintenance management system. We were able to get a terminal operations control center where our operations officers can now sit in one place and monitor everything that is going on at the airport in one place, whether it is at the runway, airside, or within the terminal building, or on the perimeter of the fence. You sit in one terminal operations control center, and you are able to see everything. And that is one of the major deliverables. The other was the air traffic services message handling system, which has revolutionized communication between pilots and our staff, the air traffic controllers, as well as communication between our people and other airports. We are now, because of that technology, able to convey more data in a short time and more efficiently and effectively.
Okay.
So that is one of the major deliverables.
What you're doing to attract more passengers at the airports or more cargo traffic at the airport?
As a country, first of all, we have entered into more bilateral air service agreements with other countries.
Yes.
We now have a total of 51 bilateral air service agreements with other countries, of which 27 are operational. Besides that, we have attracted more air operators to join Uganda's airspace. When you look at last year, we had new operators like Saudia joining Uganda's airspace. Earlier on, we had Airlink from South Africa joining Uganda's airspace to cover the gap that was left when South African Airways exited. Uganda Airlines itself commenced flights to South Africa, but not only South Africa, they also commenced flights to Dubai, and they have plans to commence flights to other destinations, including India, China, and UK, among others. We also have other air operators that joined the Ugandan airspace recently, such as Air Arabia, which commenced flights to Sharjah in UAE. Previously, we had only flights to Dubai in UAE, but Air Arabia now added another town of UAE, which is Sharjah, and many Ugandans are using that. We have Badil Airlines from Sudan that has also just started operations this year. There are also other new air operators with whom we are discussing that are planning to commence flights. For instance, Nas Air, among others, they are planning to commence flights in and out of Entebbe.
Yes.
And that is all aimed at attracting more air operators and subsequently increasing on passenger traffic in and out of Entebbe International Airport.
Okay, so how did Uganda perform at the last ICAO audit? And when is the next one due?
Okay, ICAO is the International Civil Aviation Organization, the global body that oversees aviation operations across the globe. They regularly audit member states, and Uganda is one of the member states of ICAO. We were last audited by ICAO in 2017 in what was called the Universal Security Audit Program. We scored 81% in that audit, which was well above the global average, that was 72%. There have been people that are talking and questioning the security system at Entebbe International Airport, which is not really correct. You can see that we had a security audit and scored so well in that audit. And in 2019, we were actually given a special recognition at an ICAO convention in Montreal, following that audit. But in spite of that, we have what we call continuous improvement or implementation of correction action plans. The purpose and essence of these audits is not necessarily for you to score well, but so that gaps are pointed out, and where they exist, you submit a corrective action plan and you keep implementing and covering those gaps so that all states are at the same level. So that is being done. Not only for that, but all the other audits. Next, we have the Universal Safety Oversight Audit Program that is scheduled to be conducted on Uganda as a state in November 2023.
Yes.
And we are already making preparations for that. We are implementing the corrective action plan from the previous audit so that by then, when they come, they find that we have actually implemented the things that were pointed out.
Now, last year, there was news of an accident of a plane that had landed at the airport when, in fact, it was not actually an accident, but it's the people who were falsely reporting about your emergency drills that you are required to do as a standard. Talk to us about them.
Yes, indeed. As Uganda Civil Aviation Authority, we are obliged by the International Civil Aviation Organization to conduct drills, which we call emergency exercises, every 2 years. We have the full-scale emergency exercise that we conduct every after 2 years, and we have mini drills that we conduct more regularly. This particular one that we held last year in November was actually a full-scale emergency exercise, and the purpose is to enable all the different operators who are involved in aviation operations at Entebbe International Airport to check their readiness in the unfortunate event that an aircraft accident happens at Entebbe International Airport, either on land or in water. So these drills normally cover different aspects. This particular one assumed an aircraft accident that caught fire. We have previously done drills that assume that an aircraft ditches in water. We have also previously done drills that assume an aircraft hijack. We have done that because that also can happen in the aviation industry. So all these, you are expected to test your readiness, and you call up the different stakeholders that are normally called on when an emergency happens. For instance, hospitals were called, and that's why you saw ambulances rushing to the airport. We call the different security stakeholders, the national agencies, including the army, police, and others who we normally work closely with in the unfortunate event of such an emergency. So it was just a readiness exercise. Unfortunately, some people, when they saw pictures of it, they misused. You know how people use misuse social media?
Because those photographs were all over social media. Mm. There was an accident, a plane accident. And yet, in fact, it wasn't just your drills.
It is unfortunate that some people misuse social media. And we had communicated this very well. First, before the drill happened, we saturated the statement on our social media handles, alerting the public, especially in Entebbe, not to be alarmed. Because as you undertake it and ambulances are rushing to the airport, it can cause some people get heart attacks thinking that it is real, especially if someone had a passenger that they were picking from the airport at that particular time. So we first issued a statement that morning mentioning that we are going to have an emergency exercise. And when it started, we again issued another statement. We were in touch with media houses. We had them here. That's why they covered the event, and they, on radios and everywhere, were communicating the information of what is happening. But in spite of that, someone went to social media and twisted pictures. Unfortunately, as they were playing with it, 2 days later, a real event happened in the neighboring country. That's around the time that we had an aircraft ditching in Tanzania, and yet another one also crashing in a neighboring DRC. Mm.
Tell us about the future of your organization, the Kavale International Airports. Will it be international? Will be handed over to you by Ministry of Works once it is complete. How are you expanding for Ugandans in terms of business and capacity to manage the airports?
Briefly about Kavale Airport in Hoima.
Yes.
It is a project being undertaken by the Ministry of Works and Transport.
Mm.
Uganda CAA is part of the project management team as technical experts, and when the project is completed, it will be handed over to UCAA to manage alongside all the other airports. It is a good project because it's going to give us a second international airport to Entebbe, and besides facilitating cargo operations, it will also be a good alternative to Entebbe, but more specifically, it will facilitate the oil and gas. You know that project there in Hoima, so it will facilitate those operations quite well. They are putting up a very good runway, 3.5 kilometers, almost similar to the one of Entebbe, and we are proud of that work that is going on there. But besides that one, we...
The future plans of the authority of
Entebbe.
Yes.
These projects, the many that are going on, we are looking at enhancing capacity. Once they are completed, the passenger handling capacity will be enhanced. We shall have more room for departing passengers, more room for arriving passengers. We shall have more aero bridges. At Entebbe, currently we have 2 aero bridges. When the new terminal building is completed, it will have 3 more aero bridges. So we have a total of 5 aero bridges, and these help with passengers facilitation, especially in inclement weather, whether it is raining or not. So we are looking at enhancing the passenger experience with the various projects for upgrade and expansion of the airport. Mm. Even the car parking is currently being resurfaced, and that work is about to be completed. I think right now people are experiencing a few inconveniences as they park, but when that work is completed, we shall have a bigger and more spacious facility in there.
Are you going to be licensing any more airlines?
Yes, that's correct. We license new air operators as well as renew licenses for the existing air operators. And we do this regularly. almost on a quarterly basis. For instance, on 10th March, we have a scheduled Board Air Services Licensing Committee meeting at Kampala Serena Hotel that is expected to listen to applicants for new air operations as well as those existing air operators with a view of renewing or granting air service applications to them. We normally do this and we give ample notice. The regulations require that we give 30 days notice in the papers, so we're already advertising this, calling on members of the public who may have any objection or information relating to those particular applicants. And we invite them to that public hearing so that they can give views. And after the public hearing, the board gives feedback to the applicants. So that is one major thing that we do on a regular basis as a way of attracting traffic. As I speak now, we have a total of 17 international air operators scheduled and 24 non-scheduled and ad hoc air operators who are mainly domestic and regional. The other major plan that we have is first to complete phase one of the upgrade and expansion of Entebbe International Airport. And that we are at the tail end of it. Once we complete that new terminal building, whose work is currently ongoing, and the aircraft parking apron, we will have completed the first phase of the upgrade and expansion. There is a second phase, which also involves other works. The first phase has cost $200 million. For us to undertake the second phase, we shall first go back to Parliament and seek approval for an additional funding. The total for this project is $315 million. So we already have the $200 million. So the balance, we are going to go back to Parliament and seek its approval. But it will, among others, help us cater for things like the second runway, for instance, is not lit. In the second phase, we plan to install runway lights on the second runway 12:30, so that it can also be used for night operations. We also have a number of air navigation related equipment that we plan to acquire in the second phase, among others.
Now, talking about our air tickets, how do we rank in the region in terms of how high or low the air tickets are here in Uganda?
Yes, the ticket costs are quite competitive in the region. However, there was a major milestone that we recently attained. Uganda is one of the few countries that were previously charging VAT on passenger ticket. Now, that was a disadvantage to the Ugandan air ticket because it then made it slightly more expensive by the VAT component, which is 18% of the passenger service charge that we as UCAA charge per passenger, which is a total of $50. And because of that VAT, that was coming to $7, the 18% on that charge was $7. But fortunately, through stakeholder engagements, the matter went to Parliament and it was passed and assented to by HE, the President, causing an amendment in the VAT taxation regime for air tickets. The amendment is to the effect that there will be no more. There is no more, effective last year, yes, there is no more charging of VAT on passenger service charge.
So, in short, it's the VAT that was causing our ticket to be high.
Yes, because we had a VAT component that was an extra $7. Now it is off, meaning that our ticket is now cheaper by $7. However, this is not to say that it was the VAT that was making it high. Like I said earlier on, our ticket costs are competitive in the region. But the ticket costs are contributed to by a number of factors. The biggest contributor to an air ticket is fuel. Aviation fuel is extremely expensive, and it is one of the biggest costs in the aviation industry that airlines suffer or experience. And of late, when you look at the global trend across the globe, not just in Uganda or in the region, fuel prices have gone up, not only for aviation, but even for the vehicles. But that is partly because it's attributed to the war between Russia and Ukraine. So across the globe, aviation fuel costs are high, And because of that, ticket costs across the globe have gone high, because the biggest contributor is aviation fuel to that cost. Yes. But still talking about the taxation regime, we have solved one problem in terms of the VAT.
Yes, but we still on the have cost of the air ticket.
Yes. Yes. But we still have another existing challenge, but it's a national challenge, and we are dealing with this in liaison with all the other government stakeholders. Of course, there is taxation on safety equipment. And in terms of aviation, safety and security are extremely important, very important components.
Because of the risks of losing very many lives.
Exactly. So when I talk about safety equipment, I'm talking about things like fire trucks, which are used in the unfortunate event that an aircraft crashes and catches fire. We are talking about marine boats, which we still use in the event that an aircraft ditches in water. Mm. These are very expensive equipment, and these are taxed, of course, highly. So while we bring them in very expensively, the purpose for which we use them is not to make profit. We actually put them on standby with our staff, just waiting for something to happen. For instance, a fire truck is deployed every day, but it is just on standby. Prior to a landing or a takeoff, they are just there waiting. So we are not really making money out of that deployment. Same thing with a marine boat, but these are highly taxed. So we are engaging stakeholders with a view of seeing that safety equipment taxes may either be waived or reduced.
Okay. Government has a policy that her entities must contract in shillings. And you are an authority that deals lots with the international world and suppliers who majorly deal in dollars. How are you going about this?
Yes, it is a government policy that is actually posing a little bit of challenge in our operations, because like you have rightly put it, aviation is international and global in nature. So when it comes to services and equipment, especially technical aviation equipment that we acquire, most of it is not bought from companies within Uganda. Most of it, especially when you talk about air navigation equipment and other sophisticated equipment that we use at airports to facilitate aviation operations, we buy most of these from international suppliers out of Uganda. And these definitely are not keen on engaging in shillings. They prefer to contract in either dollars, euros, or even pounds. So we face a challenge when we are actually procuring services from some of these international aviation companies. But we engage stakeholders internally and seek. There is a process for seeking waivers. Yeah. We justify our case and seek a waiver so as to contract in foreign currency. But that process of seeking a waiver takes time. Sometimes if the need is really urgent, so it can impact the time that you take seeking the waivers so as to be able to undertake such procurements in a timely manner.
What are your last remarks?
First of all, thank you very much to Urban TV for the opportunity to speak to Ugandans. Just to talk briefly about aviation training organizations. Part of our mandate is to license companies that train professionals in the aviation industry. As I speak now, we have a total of 9 licensed and approved aviation training organizations, including the East African Civil Aviation Academy in Soroti that trains pilots and aeronautical engineers, among others. We have Kajansi Flying School, operated by Ba Aviation, DAS Flying School, Aero Consultants, Kubis Aviation, among others. Those are licensed by us to train students, cabin crew, and other aviation
operations. So if the viewer is interested in becoming a pilot, they could actually go there and become pilots? Or
Not all of them can train pilots. It is only a few of them, like Soroti. Others have different courses that they are authorized to train, for instance, airport operations, cabin crew, among others. But it is important that you check that the farm you are going to is licensed by Uganda Civil Aviation Authority. Then also, in line with technology, UCAA was among the 10 pilot government entities that have been on electronic government procurement since 2020. And to date, we are on EGP. Most of our procurements now are automated, and we are moving well in that direction. Being on EGP enhances transparency because anyone out there can sit, log in and check. There was a particular bid. These are the companies that applied. This is the evaluation went on like this.
So the public can audit you.
Exactly.
So Mr. Via Niluja here is telling us you can audit them right on the internet.
Very good. Then also, in terms of passengers that are traveling through Entebbe International Airport, I would like to appeal to them to plan for more time. One of the complaints that we have received are passengers missing flights for various reasons. But when you dig deep, you realize that actually some of these passengers come late to the airport. Most international airlines close their counters 1 hour to the flight. Yes. So we encourage you to be at the airport 3 hours prior to your flight so that you can go through the various procedures that are documented, right through check-in and all those others. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you, Mr. Luja, for speaking to Urban TV. Now, that has been Checkpoint this week. We have talked about our image as a country at the main gateway with the rest of the world, but also the expansion works that are going on and the new airports after the construction works that are taking place, how it is going to be looking like, and the fact that we are going to be bigger and able to accommodate more operations at the airport. Thank you for watching.